in a sea of clouds, Navy Fighting Squadron Number 1, led by Lieutenant Commander Forrest Sherman, sweeps the skies, while far below lie the aircraft carriers Saratoga and Lexington, which house their brood of Seahawks. High in the air, the squadron forms a painted picture with a beautiful background of clouds. 10,000 feet above the carrier Saratoga and her escort cruiser, the Pensacola, as they steam for the west coast. As we pass Honolulu, which spreads out in all its tropical splendor 2 miles down, the squadron again is hidden from the earth by masses of clouds rolling over the Pacific. Watch the trio flying as one in a practice drill that tests the pilot's ability to stay in formation. Swinging together in response to commands from the flight leader as we circle above them. And look, here's a sight that you never saw before. 9 planes in a perfect line, abreast as if on dress parade, wing to wing with only a few scant yards between them. A remarkable picture of precision and skill that makes Uncle Sam's airmen the best in the world. In the Pacific, 100 warships, the bulk of America's sea power, leave the west coast for a cruise through the Panama Canal to the east coast. In the Armada are 8 light cruisers, and also 9 heavy cruisers like these, which carry 9 8-inch guns instead of the 6-inch batteries of the light cruisers. Battleships, backbone of the fleet, are also taking part of the maneuvers, which test our sea defense, and will end in New York, May 31st, with a great naval review by President Roosevelt.
States Navy.
passengers of this plane safely through fog. They landed uninjured, although the plane was a total wreck. But these disasters are now rare, thanks to pioneer work by Army Air Corps pilots. Today, a trained pilot with proper instruments can defy fog. Now we show you how Army flyers do it. Listen to an actual radio talk. Radio marker beacon. As long as he hears it, he knows he's on his course.